Therefore, since we are receiving a kingdom that cannot be shaken, let us be thankful and so worship God acceptably, with reverence and awe, for our God is a consuming fire. Thankfulness. Such an easy thing, right? We read verses such as this in church with, be thankful for everything you have. It sounds so simple, so easy to attain, but to actually live thankfulness out each and every day is a challenge, and it takes a lot of perseverance and trust to do. My grandpa, Michael Jack Siegel, was a remarkable man, and I knew him as not only my grandfather, but as my friend. It is hard to explain him to someone who's never met him, but he has such a great impact on so many people. At first glance, children would have giggled and asked if he was Santa Claus, as his fluffy white beard and twinkly blue eyes would suggest, to which he would have replied with a joyful yes. In fact, his job at the Topeka Rescue Mission had him working on Christmas Eve, so even I believed it for a long time. He was as giving and joyful as you can imagine Santa Claus would be, and all this does not even give half a glimpse into the man he was. Even though he lived with such joy, he has struggled with diabetes in his adult life, which caused him to be at high risk to the coronavirus. A year ago, he became very sick with COVID for many weeks. Once he was put on a ventilator, my family came together and prayed, waiting for whatever might happen. On the 27th of November, 2020, the day after Thanksgiving, my grandpa breathed his last and went to live with Jesus. How does any of this have to do with being thankful, you ask? I wondered that at first, too. Believe me, it is hard sometimes. But let's look at this verse in Hebrews again. Therefore, since we are receiving a kingdom that cannot be shaken, let us be thankful and so worship God acceptably with reverence and awe, for our God is a consuming fire. The author of Hebrews states that we, those who have believed in Jesus and follow him, are receiving the kingdom. The kingdom and the fact that Jesus died for us cannot be shaken or broken by the things of this world. This gospel story is the story we are a part of, from the beginning of creation to God coming in the flesh, dying, resurrecting, and giving us his spirit so that he will always be with us. This seems like a very good reason to be thankful and praise his name, if you ask me. We are also called to worship God with reverence and awe. Reverence means deep respect for something or someone, and awe, a feeling of reverential respect mixed with fear or wonder. Respect, fear, and wonder. The three go hand in hand, I think. We step back and recognize our own frailty, that the very breath we breathe is from God, inspiring reverence and awe. God uses fire several times throughout the Bible, whether it be to protect his people or display his power. A consuming fire is something that engulfs everything in its path. In this sense, it is used to describe God as one who destroys the things that are not holy, because he is holy. Jesus took on our sin and made us clean so that we can stand before God's holiness. This invokes awe and worship from our hearts as we look to the one who gave everything to have a relationship with us. My grandpa helped me see the beauty in the things God created, because he always saw beauty. Every time I see a glowing sunset through tangled branches, I will marvel at God's creation. Twinkling stars that dance across the midnight sky will forever bring a tear to my eye, because God can create wonders. And the laughter of a child will warm my heart, because God loves his children he created. I'm thankful for the wonderful man who helped me see a glimpse into true happiness, praising God and holding him above all else. So together, I hope you will join me in marveling at God's unending love, creation, and beauty. Together, we can be thankful for his unshakable kingdom, our future hope and our present hope, on earth as it is in heaven. Our God is always with us and never leaves our side. So all I ask is that you let your heart be filled with thankfulness.